Let's get right down to it. The number 20 rated Wisconsin Badgers host the our beloved and unfairly rated by the College Football Playoff Committee, number 16 Nebraska Cornhuskers, in what everyone that I know of is dubbing the Quest for the West game of the year. Okay, it's just me that call it that, but trademark. So if you want to use it, you owe me like $1 million. Actually, everybody's calling it the Freedom Trophy game, which the Big Ten really is in loving. They love that. But I'm curious if it's going to have like a sponsor, because I really hope it has like, you know, like the Little Caesars Freedom Trophy, you know? So like the team that wins gets like a, everybody from the state that has a driver's license gets a, like a $5 hot and ready pizza for free. Just wishful thinking. Alright, I hope everybody enjoyed their bye week as much as I hated mine. I cried a lot. I watched The Notebook like 12 times. It's one of my favorite movies. Ryan Gosling, if you're a bird, I'm a bird too. And that, folks, is why I'm an actor. Yeah, I know. I'm thinking the same thing. Wow, that sucked. Let's get straight down to the points of the game. Let's start off with Wisconsin. Most of the time, they have a two-quarterback rotation with Joel Stavey and Tanner McCauley, or McCauley, McKeevy, something Irish, and something I didn't look up to pronounce correctly. Oh, well. These guys are absolutely legit quarterbacks versus not very good defenses. Now, when they're playing really good defenses, not so legit. I wonder which kind of defense Nebraska has. I'm banking on a very good defense. They've literally played only two solid defenses this year. And one of them was Northwestern, so it wasn't that good because Nebraska beat Northwestern. Right? Yeah. The other one was LSU. Versus Northwestern. Northwestern got Tanner McCauley or McLeavely turned over the ball three times, three interceptions, so that's not very good. Let's talk about their stud, though. Their one-man wrecking ball, Melvin Gordon. Even though it's not really a wrecking ball. The guy is a... Every defensive coordinator in the Big Ten studies him. Studies his game, knows what he's going to do, yet no one can stop him. Are we sure he's not a god? Like Zeus or like Thor? I bet he's Loki. Definitely Loki. But the guy's a stud, and he's good friends with Amir Abdullah, and I can see why. Those two guys as running backs, I would literally take both of those running backs on the team and say, hey, which one of you has better hands and can throw the ball? You'll be our quarterback. And we'll just run the option 24/7 like the Nebraska Cornhuskers did in the, you know, back in the early 90s. He's really good in open field. He breaks a lot of tackles. So Nebraska, don't let him get it to the outside and in open space because you're going to get hurt. Oh, big time. He's going to score points on you. He's going to make big plays and you can't allow it. And you have to wrap up. Key to success, baby. That's all you gotta do. Now let's talk about their defense. Their defense gets a whole lot of recognition. And rightfully so. I mean, they lead the nation in total defense with only giving up 250 yards per game average. And they're third in scoring defense. Yet they haven't played anybody who's good on offense. I'm not knocking Wisconsin. I'm not trying to do that. Because Wisconsin obviously is 7-2 and they've won some big ball games. But not versus anybody that's decent. Yeah, you can beat, Western Michigan or Western Illinois 52-0 and get total recognition. But how many times did they punt? I mean, I don't know. And the two teams that they lost to, LSU obviously has a good offense. Should have beat Alabama last weekend. I'll forgive them later. Had 365 yards of total offense in that game and 126 yards on the ground, while Northwestern had 385 yards total game and had 203 yards rushing. I think Nebraska's going to be fine in this game. If we can get our run game going, we can get to the outside, hit the perimeter, because Wisconsin's defense likes to push, likes to take those two defensive ends and make sure they get the C gap and pretty much cover the outside and try to take everybody up the middle. So if Nebraska can get to the outside, but then again, I think we're going to be fine going up the middle too. I don't know. So my first guest, I have two guests coming in today. They're going to be back to back, two segments. The first segment is the two teams that Nebraska needs to be rooting for this weekend to help us in the playoff picture. And I'm going to bring him on right now. He's a good friend of mine. He doesn't like a lot of people, so I'm sorry if he says some bad things about a certain person that no one in Nebraska likes. So I'm going to go get him right now. He'll be right out. Shoot! Hello there! I am Fat Bing! And here I am to tell you two teams you should be rooting for this weekend, Nebraska! But first and foremost, I wrote a speech just for you. Citizens of Nebraska! And all Cornhusker fans nationwide. It seems to me that the College Football Playoff Committee gives you no respect. They do not like you. They are not very smart, except for you, Dr. Tom. You're very smart and very cool. I really like you. If you know, but I heard you're friends with Batman. Whatever, whatever. So, I think when it comes to this, Nebraska needs to be rooted for people to lose. And the first game, I know everybody's going to hate it. I hate it. But you need to root for Urban Meyer and Ohio State to win. I know it's bad. But you need to root for Minnesota to keep it close. Keep Minnesota ranked so that when we play them next week, we beat them. Ohio State needs to win so they keep looking good, and then Nebraska beats them in the Big Ten Championship game. Okie dokie. Game two. And this is a really good friend of mine. Nebraska fans don't like him either. But all about the U-83. Nebraska stands with you this weekend. Go Miami Hurricanes! Go the U! Jameis Winston is a criminal. Kinda like myself. But he's worse. He steals crab legs. And he kinda beats up women. What a douchebag. He should be in jail. I hope you all punish him. Take him to the ground and give him your worst nightmare and beat Florida State. They suck. You deserve this big time. No one likes Al Golden, but this would be huge. So all about the U-83. Us Nebraskans are rooting with you for the Miami Hurricanes. So, without further ado, I will give it back to my good friend Derek, who is really cool and, like, really awesome and stuff and funny. He's cool. So that, my friends, is two games, two teams you should be rooting for this weekend. Let the games begin. Peace easies. And that, my friends, was Fat Bane. Good friend of mine. Really good friend of mine. And he's really kind, too. He said some really nice things about me. He is very accurate. All right, let's get down to our second guest, folks. He is also a very good friend of mine. Very hyper, very interesting. But I think you'll like him. I'm going to put him up because he likes to stand up when he talks. I hope you enjoy him, Husker fans. He's been down in my basement all day long. I think he's been drinking that full pot of coffee too, so I'm not for sure about that. I'm like 50% sure. But he's going to tell you all about some keys to winning this game this weekend. Oh, here he comes. All right. How's everybody doing? Good. Good. Now, as your friend Derek Arthur probably told you, my name is Matt Foley, and I am a motivational speaker. Now, you're probably all asking yourself, hey, Matt, what can we do as Nebraska Cornhuskers to win the game this weekend? Well, I'll tell ya. First and foremost, you wide receivers need to run the correct routes so we don't throw interceptions. Just think about it. It's kind of easy. You're smart. I think you can do it. I see some smart Shakespeare's over there. Okay, all right. Also, Vincent Valentine. And our whole defensive line, especially you, Vincent. I saw you on Twitter, and you said that the college football playoff committee gives you no respect, and that they considered last week's bye a nail. Little friend, hear what you can do. You can take that quarterback, wrap him up, bring him down, and put him in your pocket and show him what the ground tastes like. Now, also, the college football committee. Seems like they're full of a bunch of jokers, except for that Tom Osborne. He's a cool guy. They're probably saying to themselves, oh, hey there. SEC rules, Pac-12 rules, I'm Pat Hayden, and I think everybody's good. Well, I'll tell them that they can just shut their mouth, yapper. Now, that is my keys to winning versus Wisconsin. Now, Abdullah. Amir Abdul, I'm going to be moving in with you, pal. We're going to be buddies. We're going to be pals. There's you. There's me. There's you. Here's me. We're going to wrestle. No, we're not. We're not going to get you injured. But if it's on the outside and your knee still hurts, I'm going to go to class for you. Because I'm tired of living in a van down by the Platte River. So I'll see you in about 24 hours, Amir Abdullah. Go Big Red. Wow, that guy was interesting. He's funny, though. I like him. Oh, man. So that was Matt Foley with this week's keys to win the game. My prediction time. I got Nebraska 38. Wisconsin, 31. I think we can win this game. I think we can, you know, quest for the West, baby. And as one of my favorite TV shows of all time, which is Friday Night Lights, of course, I'm going to finish with this. Clear eyes, full hearts, and as Kenny Bell said, just win. Nebraska, forever. Thanks for watching, folks. I'm your host, Derek Arthur. Go Big Red, beat Wisconsin.